controlled supply chain consisting of storage and distribution activities designed to maintain products at a given ambient level. So here we have tried to build up a snapshot of the value chain. So right from supply procurement through transportation to surface storage, distribution to end customers.
So what we see that various facets of the cold chain, right from procurement from the farmers, sorting and grading, and then pre-cooling. Now pre-cooling is almost not present in India, but it is a very important factor in cold chain, because without pre-cooling we cannot get the we cannot extend the life of the our producers, and it is a very important factor in cold chain. After that there is refrigerated transport, cold storage, and information system for tracking, because we want to know when the produce was harvested and how many days it has been in the cold chain and when we have to utilize it. And then these are the various functions of the cold chain. What we want from the cold chain, we want to have longer shelf life, we want safety and quality of the food, we want to reduce the wastage, we want to extend markets. Essentially, cold chain is not to extend seasonality, it is to extend the market. We want traceability and we want to support retail and food processing industry in India.
So, talking about cold chain market, the market is expected to grow from 153.3 billion to 381.5 billion. So, in this particular slide, we are basically trying to segment cold chain market assets. So we have cold storage as a transportation. The cold storage or surface storage is constitutes 25% of the market, and refrigerated transport it contributes 15%. So currently, what we have in our country is a static system, not a dynamic one compared to other advanced countries.
So if we compare with US, US has almost 50% of its cold storage capacity in cold chain capacity in cold storage and 50% in transportation. So basically in a supply chain, what we want is our produce should always be in motion, which is not done in India. 85% of the storage is in surface storage. So and that too was skewed towards potatoes. Around 56% of the cold storage is being used for potatoes. So what we want essentially is to shift our static cold chain towards a more dynamic and mobile cold chain. So for that we want more number of refrigerated transports.
So add to what Hassan said, so that too the cold storage are skewed in certain states, they don't cover the entire country. And also the high margin, the refrigerated transport costs only 15%. Now we present before you the lead gap analysis of the major segments.